Hello and welcome to the channel. Today I am here with an interesting case of a patient suffering from gout. This patient had been on oral steroid medications for a long time, and because of which he developed a posterior subclavicular cataract, and for which he presented to us. And let's start with the surgery. By this time, one side put has been made. The anterior capsule has been stained with a trypan blue dye. The patient is a young patient of about 38 years of age. Rex has been initiated with the help of a 26 gauge bend needle cystitome, and the anterior capsule flap is moved slowly. I am aiming for a capsule excess of a size of about 5.5 millimeters. Rexus is then completed using a 23 gauge micro Rexus forceps through the side port. A 2.8 3 planar main port is made using a steel keratome. Hydro dissection is one of the key factors, key steps when we are dealing with soft posterior subcapsular cataracts. Multiple hydro dissection waves are passed to remove the cortex from the capsule. Now is the time to enter the eye with the phaco needle. As the cataract was soft, it was relatively easy to emulsify the nucleus and the epinucleus as a whole. Some of the sub-incisional epinucleus could not be mobilized using the phaco handpiece, and here I am doing a visco dissection with the help of HPMC so that the sub-incisional epinucleus could be brought in the center and then comfortably removed. Now with the help of a coaxial irrigation aspiration handpiece, the remaining epinucleus and the cortex was then removed comfortably. capsular bag is now being filled up with HPMC to make some space for intraocular lens implantation. In this case, I have selected a hydrophobic foldable intraocular lens with aspheric optics. The leading haptic goes into the capsular bag and the trailing haptic is now being dialed into the capsular bag. Now is the time to remove the viscoelastic substance both from behind the intraocular lens and in front of the intraocular lens. It is very important to thoroughly remove all the viscoelastic from the eye before closing the eye so as to avoid any post-operative rise of intraocular pressure. Some intracameral air is being instilled. Intracameral moxifloxacin. And all the incisions are now being closed using saline. Good stromal hydration is being done at the main port. Side ports are also closed with stromal hydration, and that is the end of the case. Thank you so much.